Hello, I'm Brad. Today I'm going to talk to you about some misconceptions of the scriptures and in the Bible in general, and how Christians are deceived with these scriptures. For one thing, the scriptures were not intended for sinners to read. Never. Disobedient sinners, okay, and the reason is because the sins of their flesh, the genetic sins, cause power to deceive their thoughts, so they can't possibly interpret the scriptures correctly. They might be able to get a few scriptures understood in their way, and you know, collectively come up with some kinds of ideas, but it's always going to turn out wrong. Always. The end result is going to be way off of God's plan. It's not going to be right. For one thing, what happens is sinners that become religious like this always put themselves above other sinners. They start reading some of these scriptures that talk about sins, and they don't want to look at themselves as a sinner anymore. Oh no, they're religious now. You know, they're hearing God, and you know, they can't be a sinner anymore. And then they read these scriptures in there that talk about hell and so forth, and that totally deceives them. They think they're somebody different than who they are. Well, if you read the scriptures, they're written by saints. And they're written by prophets. They're not written by people called Christians. Nowhere in there is any word written by a Christian. They're all written by authorized saints, sinless saints. Okay, by then, by the New Testament time, after Jesus, they had to be sinless in order to write and get anything from God. If you were a sinner on your way to becoming a saint, then you were just being commanded to become sinless. That's all it was. You don't get to go read in the scriptures unless God guides you to something, which He did to me. For 2 days I had to look up some scriptures. That was it. That's all I got to look up for 2 days in 29 years that I was with God. That's all He had me look up. Now earlier, 25 years ago, He had me involved in Christianity, and I had to read the Bible for 2 years. He gave me a desire so strong that, I mean, I couldn't put it down. I read that thing constantly. But it wasn't for learning anything. It wasn't for me to retain anything and to use it for preaching or teaching. It was used for a vocabulary, and that's it. Nothing else but a vocabulary. So after two years of reading it, I got enough of vocabulary in my memory, deep in my memory, because I don't have good recall. In fact, I can't repeat a scripture. I can't try memorize a scripture and then repeat it. It doesn't work for me. But so I left, God forced me out of Christianity after 9 years of being involved. I didn't know anything. I couldn't remember any scriptures. I couldn't remember nothing. And then 15 years later, well, about 14 years, Benny goes and has me read 2 days worth of, and it wasn't even 2 days worth. I'd say it took me probably 3-4 hours at the most in those 2 days to look up these scriptures and then write them down in some notebooks. That was all He wanted me to know. And then once He made me a sinless saint about 6 months later, then of course I got the knowledge of God. With this knowledge, it's a living knowledge, it's who I am. Okay? That's who I am in my created state. In my created form, in God. I am the Word. This Word is knowledge. And this is where I get taught. When I write, it all comes out in my writing. When I speak, I learn a lot of things. But usually it's harder when you're speaking because you're concentrating on that. But when you're writing, you can see it. It's much easier to catch. So these saints all wrote, you know, for God, while God was teaching them. And that's where they were learning. A lot of them were letters. They were writing back and forth, teaching. No, I don't know why they wrote letters back and forth. It didn't make any sense. Sometimes I don't even really totally believe that. I think they were all made up. So, because I know that the Roman government killed all the saints. Okay, I know that. And the Jews weren't satisfied with just Jesus dead. They wanted everybody dead who spoke to, or who preached the gospel. So they convinced the Romans to kill them all. So they killed all the saints, and they had a lot of followers left over that were listening to the saints. They were walking along with them, probably, you know, or just waiting for them to come back from their outing. I don't know how they worked back then, but I do know they had a lot of followers. And these, a lot of them were believers. A lot of them had listened to the gospel, and God revealed himself to them, so they became believers. But they were still sinners who were using or listening to the commands by God through these saints to get them to confess sins, to get them to repent of them, and then so God could change their genetic sins and make them sinless saints. Well, this was a process of time. It could take years and years. It took me 29 years, but then I'm different. I didn't have a saint to follow. There wasn't any around. So God took it real slow with me. So I suppose some people became saints in maybe in less than a year even. And others probably took many, many years. Everybody had his own time. God had a plan for each one of them, because they all had differing types of sins in them. Now, Paul was a murderer. He killed saints. So I'm sure he had a difficult time to confess and repent of sins. You know, it wasn't overnight, I know that. he didn't just confess like that. You know, he was led to Damascus, and he had to meet this Ananias, I think his name was. And he was a saint, and then he had to work with Ananias to become a sinless saint. So however long that took, it doesn't say anything in the Bible how long, but it could have taken him a year, two, maybe 3 years before Paul was actually a sinless saint who could go out and start preaching the gospel. So yeah, it's nothing like Christians think it is. Not even close. They just think it's words in a book, and that's the words God gave them. No, God didn't give you any words. You're a sinner. You're all sinners. Every Christian is a sinner. They have never been a sinless saint. I know that because they don't believe in sinlessness. If they were a sinless saint, then they would believe it. So that's easy for me to catch that. Anyway, I'll go to the next tape here.